For lovers of comic books, you're gonna find this video very helpful. Hey guys, so di video kali ini aku bakal sharing ke kalian beberapa tips, beberapa cara untuk belajar bahasa Inggris secara otodidak lewat baca komik. If you go to one of the biggest books, local bookstore in Indonesia, there is probably like a dedicated floor just for comic books. Okay, as you can see, I love reading comic books. Okay, aku suka baca komik, and I'm also a Miiko fanatic. I even went to the meet and greet session with the author of Miiko last year. In this video, I'm gonna tell you that reading comic books is actually an underrated method to learn English. Oke, bahasanya agak campur aduk sedikit ya. Di video kali ini, aku bakal saranin kalian, daripada kalian harus ke toko buku dan beli buku, lumayan mahal kan sekarang komik. Dulu cuma 9.000 perak, sekarang it's like, I don't know, 20.000-an, 50.000-an. Mendingan kalian baca buku komik di internet pakai bahasa Inggris. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you a few reasons on why reading comic books in English is a very good way to learn the language, to learn a language. Not even English, even other languages that you wanna learn. Alasan pertama adalah kalian gak akan ngerasa kayak lagi belajar. Apalagi buat kalian yang emang hobi baca komik. Jadi kalian itu menemukan aktivitas yang kalian suka, yang kalian enjoy, and at the same time it's beneficial for you, for your brain, and also for your language skills. So it's like, it's a good combo. Dua, just like watching series on Netflix, baca komik itu juga bisa menjadi aktivitas yang addictive. Because, you know, when you guys are watching series on Netflix, you just want to keep on going to the next episode, and then, well, it's also the same with comic books as well. So comic books could be addictive. At least for me, it's very addictive. Once I read only one volume, I can't stop. I would go on like the entire series and like one go. Kombinasi ilustrasi dan teks dalam bahasa Inggris, apalagi dalam kebanyakan komik itu, teks dalam bahasa Inggrisnya kan suka apa? Pendek-pendek. You know, it's not really like long strings of sentences like a novel, right? So if you combine those short sentences with the images, you are able to learn a lot quicker. Ini adalah cara yang bikin kalian cepet nangkep dan lama nempel di kepala kalau misalnya kalian belajar dengan begini. Next one is that you don't always have to open your dictionary for that. The illustration in the comic books will just kind of do the translation for you, you know? So if you really don't know what a word means, of course you can always use a dictionary, but just by seeing the images that go with it, you could kind of guess what is happening, what is the context, what could this word possibly mean. Jadi, you know, it gets you to think a little bit more. Nah, ini akan membantu kalian belajar secara konteks dan gak menerjemahkan kata per kata. Karena disertai gambar, jadi kalian tuh bisa nebak-nebak situasi dan keadaannya apa. Apalagi kalau misalnya kalian belum tahap comfortable untuk belajar, untuk baca novel full dalam bahasa Inggris, ini adalah, this is a good prerequisite for that. Because sometimes if you are reading a book in English and you come across a word that you don't know, it's going to kind of hinder your ability to imagine what is happening at that moment, right? But you don't really have this in comic books because they're doing the imagination for you. They're doing the visuals for you. You don't really have to visualize in your head. You can just see what is happening. Another reason why it's really good is because it's ini gampang diakses. You can easily do a Google search and you will find any comic books you want. Maybe not any, but let's say buku-buku komik yang popular lah ya, yang kayak Detective Conan atau Doraemon atau Miiko atau One Piece, Naruto, Dragon Ball and all that, pasti kalian bisa akses ini di internet just with a simple Google search. Misalnya kalian suka apa? Suka Miiko, because I love Miiko, okay? So let's use that as an example, okay? Read Miiko manga online for free.
Halo. Nah, buat sekarang aku pakai kamera HP dulu karena kameraku yang Canon itu lagi rusak dan lagi di service, jadi tolong maklumi kualitasnya. Nah, aku mau explain buat ke kalian, kalau misalnya kalian punya komiknya dalam bahasa Indonesia dan kalian juga punya bisa nemuin komik ini dalam bahasa Inggris versinya, you guys are very lucky karena dengan ini kalian bisa nerjemahin dalam bahasa Indonesia dan dalam bahasa Inggris sendiri. Jadi kalian bisa ngebandingin bahasanya. Maksudnya apa? Begini.
Nah, kita coba pakai contoh salah satu komik kesukaan aku, komik cewek banget. Kalian dalam begini bisa belajar ekspresi-ekspresi bahasa Indonesia yang gak bisa diterjemahin secara langsung ke bahasa Inggris. Misalnya nih, ada apaan sih? Bahasa Inggrisnya apa ya? Kayak
Nah, biasanya kan orang suka bingung, mikirnya kayak, apaan sih tuh bahasa Inggrisnya apa ya? Kalau misalnya kita lihat terjemahannya,
dalam bahasa Inggris diterjemahkannya, what was that all about? At least dalam konteks ini, this is how you would say it in English. Jadi, dengan cara begini, kalian bisa belajar beberapa untranslatable expressions, collocates, phrasal verbs, yang nggak bisa ditemukan kalau misalnya kalian menerjemahkan itu secara kata per kata.
Easier. Mudah-mudahan ini bisa kalian membantu kalian untuk bisa cari sumber dalam bahasa Inggris lebih baik di internet. So, that is it. So this is it for this video. I hope you like it and I hope you learned something new. And as usual, if you like it, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And also share this with your friends, with your family, with your classmates if you think this is helpful. So I will see you next time. Bye!